Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Recombo, here at the London launch of the new Google Pixel 2, which I am holding in my right hand. And in my left hand, I'm holding last year's Google Pixel. So I thought I'd just place the two phones side by side so you know exactly where the differences lie. So let's start with the front here. So both phones feature 5-inch full HD displays, both are AMOLED panels as well. So both offer really great colors, contrast, they're both very responsive, surprisingly good overall brightness as well. The user experience on offer here is slightly different, even though this has been updated to Android Oreo. This phone launches on Android Oreo, and you'll notice the differences out the gate. So whilst both feature a swipe up to get to your app store, the search bar is now down on the bottom on the new launcher found on the Google Pixel 2. That said, you'll still get fundamental similarities like Google Assistant, which you can long press the home button to get at. Another way of doing that with the new Google Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL is actually, they call it Active Edge, which is a trait that they've actually pulled over from HTC's engineers, so they've just brought in to their own family. So you can squeeze the phone and call the assistant in that way, and I believe that setting is customizable. There's no such grip feature on the Pixel 1 or the original Pixel, so you don't have that functionality there. At the top, we have 8-megapixel cameras all round. You get a wider aperture on the front of the Pixel 2, obviously, so you should get superior low light performance. And another thing worth noting is the front-facing stereo speakers. So now, on the Pixel 2, you can see there's one up here, and there's one down the bottom of the display, where there's only the earpiece up the top on the original Pixel, and then there's the camera-facing speaker at the bottom here. Another thing that Google has shifted away from is the headphone jack, which is actually one of the big selling points of the first Pixel. They've actually now done away with that completely on the Pixel 2. So you'll notice there's a Type-C USB connection at the bottom, but there isn't any headphone jack. Instead, they're including an adapter in-box, so you can use headphones that way if you have standard 3.5mm headphone jack headphones there. Otherwise, you have to use USB set headphones, or you can use Bluetooth 5.0 with AppTech support, and hopefully AppTech HD support for high-fidelity music streaming wirelessly as well. So you have that functionality in there too. The bodies are quite different as well. Both feature this kind of visor, glass visor design at the top. Obviously, they've shifted that up with the Pixel 2 over the regular Pixel. But also the body material is different. So this feels like a polycarbonate shell, but with metal hardware controls, whereas this is an aluminium body. They feel distinctly different. As such, the original, the Pixel 2, excuse me, actually feels a little bit lighter, which is quite nice. And the camera, the fingerprint sensor, excuse me, before I get to the cameras, both feature this centrally positioned rear fingerprint sensor. The one on the Pixel 2 is apparently the fastest around, so we will be testing it out thoroughly to see how good it is. The one on the original Pixel was pretty good, but if it's faster, that's always good, always appreciated. And the last thing to talk about on the back here is the cameras. Both feature a laser autofocus system, both have a dual LED flash, both feature 12 megapixel sensors. This has, I believe, is an f2.0 aperture. This one features a f1.8 aperture, so a wider aperture, 1.4 micron pixels, technically smaller pixels than on the original Pixel. But it also features an OIS system, which might account for the ever so slight camera bump. There's no camera bump on the original Pixel, but there is a slight one on the Pixel 2. But we'll take that for the benefit of OIS as well as EIS. So the hybrid system that it has there should smooth out your videos and make sure your photos look great, especially low light photos. There's a lot of promise. There's a nice big sensor. It looks really promising, and we'll be testing it out thoroughly come before review time. The last thing to really mention on these two phones as well is the, even though Google didn't really shout about it when the original phone launched, the original Pixel is actually IP63 certified, so it has some level of dust and water resistance. Meanwhile, the Google Pixel 2 is IP67 certified. So it's the same level of protection that you get on the likes of the iPhone 7, 7 Plus, 8 and 8 Plus, but it's in an Android phone and it's one made by Google. This phone features 4GB of RAM and a Snapdragon 81, which at the time was one of the best chipsets on the market. This phone features a Snapdragon 835, which has arguably been the processor of choice in 2017 for a flagship Android smartphone. We were kind of hoping for the 836, but it still means this is going to be a perfectly fine, powerful phone, really fast, ready for Daydream VR and Daydream View, of course, which is Google's own VR headset. It'll be perfectly good with that, and that AMOLED screen tech also means it's really going to be really, really pretty, really easy on the eyes. Beyond that, both phones feature fast charging, giving you about 7 hours use after just 15 minutes charge time. And yeah, that's basically everything I can think of right now, but there's arguably more to talk about, which you can read on recombo.com. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell for notifications so you don't miss one. And thanks for watching.